Good morning.
Good morning.
Thank all of y'all for being here. Bobby Head with the Commerce Department. It's a remarkable day for Team South Carolina. And today was made possible because of the collaboration and hard work of many, many people in this room. And so I'm pleased to kick off this program. First, I want to invite you, I'm sure your eyes cast upon this beautiful plant that's being built here. Kind of been the secret behind the trees. Be the first time some of you have had a chance to see it. West Katharina, Katharina is right here. This has been the object of her attention for the last 2 years. And so it's a remarkable thing we now have a beautiful new plant being built here. So to kick things off and make this big announcement, first I'd like to introduce my friend Lex Kirschner, President and CEO of Volvo Cars North America.
This factory will be fully operational
and will start to produce the S60, and the S60 will be sold globally. This is the entity where that car will be produced. In the meantime, the company in the United States is expanding our activities in the western part, in Mountain View in California, to be part of all the digital development and also autonomous drive, and everything which has to do with electronics and digital is slowly but gradually, what we say here, moving from Europe into the United States, because that's where it's happening. And that is all, that development is all pretty remarkable for a brand about which journalists wrote only 7 years ago that it was going to disappear out of the United States. And believe me, launching the factory 2 years ago, and by then launching also 5 new cars since 2015, since the past 32 months, that factory announcement and launching new cars in the United States made also our retailers to invest. And I'm extremely proud and happy to say that out of the 300 partners we have in the United States, over 200 did exactly the same what we are doing here, investing in facilities. And that means that 200 have hyper-modern facilities. They are investing $2 to $5 to $6 million to secure that they represent the Volvo brand in absolutely, absolutely the correct way. And of course, all those investments are happening for a reason. First, because they believe in Volvo, and we believe in ourselves, otherwise we wouldn't have done it here. But it's very important to say is that we also invest in a society which is stable, in a society which has shown entrepreneurship over all those years. And yes, there are a lot of discussions, and in all fairness, we have been a little bit hesitant. Should we go for a second car in Charleston? Because with all the discussions ongoing, is the United States still the right place to invest in? Our conclusion is yes, and that's why we're here today to announce that in this factory, as from 2021, the XC90, our flagship SUV, will also be built in these facilities here behind us. We will give the team here the time to make it all running flawless. Because you know, mid next year, mid 18, the S60, then around 2021, we expect that car will start production here. That will expand the capacity, that will expand the number of people we are going to employ with about 1,900 people. That brings us, when the factory is fully running, brings us to around 4,000 people. And just imagine what it means, because a lot of people who know how to extrapolate those numbers and what it brings to the local economy. But I've been told that without any problem, you can extrapolate those numbers and multiply them by 5. So by 2021, say 2022, this region here will have an equivalent of around 20,000 people directly and indirectly working with this facility. And that makes us, of course, very proud that we can contribute. By then, the total capacity of this factory will be around 150,000. And it's very important to say that every car we produce here will be a global car. Big parts will go to the United States, but the rest will be sold globally. And of course, I can repeat why we are here. We elected this place 2 years ago, 2.5 years ago, because of the entrepreneurship, because of the infrastructure, because of the attitude. And I can stand here on stage today, like, after 2 years working with the county, with the state, with all the entrepreneurs here in the region, we have never regretted it one second that we elected South Carolina as our partner to do so. And I really, really would like to start. Center, which is under construction as we speak. Next to that training center, we will build an office which can facilitate 300 people. This office will be occupied by people from purchasing, people from production, and people from the quality, both to the American quality team as the manufacturing quality team, but also the regional sales team from Volvo Car USA, responsible for selling and distribution of our cars, will also be in that office. So we are proud to be here, we are happy with the choice we made, and I can only stress you that Volvo will continue to think out of the box. As we have announced, by 2019, none of our cars we launch as from then will, or all our cars will have any sort of electrification. Autonomous drive will continue to be our journey. We will tackle the customer demands in a different way. We will start to invent or start to launch new models how to own a car. Mobility, care by Volvo, all these sort of concepts. And in the meantime, I truly hope that South Carolina, but also the United States, keeps their arms wide open for entrepreneurs like us. Thank you very much.
Pretty easy to see why sales are up. This has been an exciting adventure for the last 2 years. It's been an especially exciting adventure for me. And next, I'd like to introduce the thanking Lex. I get the opportunity to introduce my boss. Since taking office in January, going to him, McMaster, has been busy helping us advance economic development. So at this time, I'd like to welcome our leader, my friend, Governor Henry McMaster.
Very clear, everyone.
this is where it's going to happen. There's no place, there's surveys, there's studies, it's the southern United States, it's the southeast, it's the southern, the airport, the Charleston, with the sunshine, all the things that we have here that we can offer to these companies for our people. Everybody recognizes this. So, well, ladies and gentlemen, this the best is still yet to come. It's getting mighty good, but the best is still yet to come. And with South Carolina, the people of South Carolina, and the relationship we have with this magnificent company, Volvo, I think it's best expressed at the end of the community, Casablanca. I think this is the beginning of a beautiful relationship that's going to work. So we thank you, Volvo.
Found out it was only going to be the XC60, I thought, Something's got to happen. Well, Lex, thank you so much. Chairman CEO B, thank you so much. I'm looking forward to a long, pleasant relationship as this XC90 validates my pronunciation, which is absolutely out of the top of my head several weeks ago. But thank you so much, and thanks to all of you who continue to make this part of South Carolina a place where people, for as long as I can remember, loved to visit. You are now making it a place that people look forward to living, recreating, and planning the future. Because what Volvo is doing here today redefines the future of Low Country, South Carolina. And having come here 56 years ago to pick up a ride, I know you're making a significant and lasting investment in this great community, and thank you so much.
Call, we get in and out. care of the needs and problems that arise here, because we are committed to Volvo, and as Volvo is committed to us. They exemplify what Volvo means to this community by their hard work and their commitment, and I want to tell you openly and in public how much I appreciate it. Volvo is a game changer for us, and what I didn't expect is that, you know, we're going to have, you know, my friend Lattis, okay? I got to know him by virtue of our first meeting out here, and over time, we've talked several times, and I got a nice picture from him with a note that says, you know, that he would be my friend, and I truly believe that. And with this investment, we are over $1 billion, that is billion with a B dollars, in Volvo in Berkeley County. I think that deserves a round of applause. That's how much Volvo has now invested here. It's near 4,000 jobs, which let's set by five, that's 20,000 jobs. Well, that would be 4,000, because you multiply that plus the 4 near my Berkeley County. Math, but it seems to work that way. I get calls every day from people around the country asking about how to get a job here, how to contact a company here, or just wanting to find out more information. The reason here is we're here today is for the first car rolls off the assembly line. They're announcing this investment. This speaks to Volvo's faith in Berkeley County, South Carolina, and the United States. This brings their Berkeley County's economic cumulative investment since I took office. But again, that's not just me alone, to more than $2.5 billion. I think that's very impressive for Berkeley County, and I'd like y'all to give us a applause.
Promoted Jennifer Noel.
Fletcher to deputy of the department, and at the same day said, and you get to be the project manager of Volvo, which she has done very, very well, which I appreciate. And also I have my railroad team here with Jeff McWhorter and his staff. We'll be building a railroad to cross. We'll be working on that over the next few years. And our team at Commerce has worked pretty tirelessly on this, both in terms of workforce development as well as ready development of this site. And I thank everybody for that. We don't normally say nice things about things like the U.S. Army Corps of Engineers, but I want to tell you what a great team they are. They're here in the back. The Army Corps was with us on this site from day one and helped us bring this site to fruition in a time frame that would work for this project. And we did it without cutting any corners, but boy, we sure turned them sharp. And I appreciate their support, along with our state government folks. See Shelley there from DHEC. We have a great relationship across our government agencies. DHEC has been here with us every step of the way, working in harmony with the Army Corps, as well as with all the permitting and other things that are required for a challenging development like this. My dear friends from Santee Cooper, again, at first meeting with Supervisor Piegler, also included the leadership of Santee Cooper, where I told him, this is how much you're going to need to spend, and you're not getting out of this room until you say yes. Everybody said yes. So, and the Ports Authority, Jim Newsom, my partner from the Ports Authority, is not here today because they had to move the State of the Port event, which had been planned a couple of weeks ago until, you know, that most recent storm came through. And so they're preparing for that. He couldn't be here. The Port is a huge partner for us on this project. And without the Port, projects like this wouldn't come about. As you heard, this is an export site, and we're an export state, and that word of the Port is key to us. All these partners play an intricate role. All of it has to fit together. It means all of us have to get together and work on these issues and refine them along the way, and then come back and refine them again and again. So for Volvo to double its commitment, it is a tribute to all of the partners in this room and other partners around. This is a landmark moment for us. Ladies and gentlemen, we have three OEMs in this state. All of them are remarkable brands, and Volvo is the newest shining star. And no state has anything like what we have in South Carolina. We couldn't be prouder of the newest vehicle, most advanced vehicle in the Volvo line coming to South Carolina. So this is a huge and important moment for us. We're now a brand state. You know, 25 years ago, we made brake law. Today, we make remarkable objects that roll on the ground and fly in the air. This is about the people who live and work here in South Carolina. And the leadership behind me that has made this come about. We all stand on a lot of shoulders. I might say a couple of shoulders here are fairly old, and so we can stand on them. I'm picking on them because they're both older than me. But we're now a top global destination for business. All around the world, people know South Carolina. In our neighboring states, they know South Carolina. And our automobile industry is thriving. We have over 400 automotive-related companies in the state. We have a very strong supplier system. One of the reasons that Volvo was attractive to us. We lead the nation in the export sales of completed passenger vehicles. Nearly 20% of the export vehicles in this country come from South Carolina, and that's going to do nothing but go up with the culmination of this project over the next few years. And once that's up, we're just off to the races. So with that, I'll be glad to open the floor to questions from the press. That's right, this is a press conference. So, if there are any questions from the press, one of us will be delighted to answer them. We'll have the fielder and the rest. No questions? Lovely. I did not mention my dear friend from Class 1 Railroad. CSX? You have one? Anyway, I just wanted to recognize Carl and Kelly from CSX, one of our partners on this side. Yes, ma'am.
I've got the describer of Jeep right here.
don't see in the room, you can hear in the room now that I'm talking about it. It's our XC90. It's probably one of the SUV who has won the most awards since we launched it, from a safety perspective, from a fuel efficiency perspective, from an efficiency perspective. And it's our flagship. It's our leading SUV, which is also our flagship in respect of electrification, because we offer the plug-in hybrid technology. So you can drive an electrical, and you can drive in your regular combustion engine with fuel. And we will introduce that technology, or have introduced that technology already, on the cars we have launched since.
For you as well, how many exports are you expecting to do for the XC90 within first 6 months, first year?
As we are talking about 2021, I'm a little bit reluctant to give percentages about export and the US market, but I would assume 50-50.
And I know with the first car, it was going to be exclusively made here. Is this car going to be made elsewhere, or and part of it here, or?
That is still to be decided. This is the first step on the next generation manufacturing footprint. So that we will announce probably in 6 months. But it starts here. That's the most important message.
Anything else? Going once, going twice. Thank you all very much for being with us today.